All right, guys, welcome back to the Tutor Learning Center and North Range Academy. This is JD Tutor, and I'm here to teach you more about Y equals MX plus B. All right, so guys, let's do a few little more technical things to learn about. So last video, we already knew, let me get my pencil out. First off, let's do the formula. Y equals MX plus B. Okay. All right. So last time we already knew that this mx right here, or this m, could be interchangeable with a plus or a minus. It could be an increase or a rise over run or a decrease over run. All right. And let's see. Last video, we discovered that this also could be a positive or a negative interchangeable. And so we found out that if they're both positives, that's going to, this positive right here on the 1/2 is going to put your slope upward. If you did a negative, it was going to put your slope downward. All right. Let's go back up. Just a little recap for you here before we get on to what we're supposed to be doing. All right. And we discovered that if you go to the y-intercept, that if you put that a negative, it was going to put it in a different quadrant. It was going to move it down, all right? So if you did both of them negative, it was going to put that downward, put that down in another quadrant, and also flip the slope going downward. So these signs do matter, guys. It does matter because it matters about the location on the graph. You know, what your problem is going to turn out to be. All right. So we want to make sure that we have the right signs when we're copying down what the problem should be. All right. So let's get on with it, guys. So let's say we have a whole number here. Let's say we have 4x plus 3. All right. So a whole number. You're like, now I don't know what to do with my rise over run. Yeah, sure you do. Because it's the same thing. Let's put our x out here. How do we create a rise over run if we have just a whole number there? What do you do? How do you create a fraction when you just have a whole number? You put it over a 1, right? Plus the 3. Actually, that's supposed to be a plus 3 for now. So plus 3. All right, so now let's do our rise over run. So we have our y-intercept plus 3, rise up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and over 1, and yes, it touches our line there. All right. All right, what if we had, let's see, what if we had our negative 3? It's going to drop that down to another quadrant, right? Oh, actually, it moved it over a little bit more that way. Because I guess of the nature of the slope. So let's see, negative 3. So we're going down here into the negative here, and it's still a positive 4 there. So up, so rise, 1, 2, 3, 4, and over 1, because we put that 4 over a 1 to create our rise over run. What about this negative 4? That now we're going downward. I just turned the slope downward. What if I did both of them? That moved it back over that way. So downward and back over it that way into another quadrant. All right. So what happens if I have a positive 4 and a nothing here? Okay, remember what I said on the first video? You can put a 0 there just to kind of fill in the B. Whatever's missing, you can put a 0 there. Okay, otherwise we'll just leave it blank. Okay, it's the same difference, and that's going to start us off right here on the origin. where there's a zero there. All right. Because after all, this is going to be our y-intercept, right? Nothing's going to be there. We can put a zero. So our y-intercept and go down and put that zero right there. That dot right there on the zero. All right. Let's see. And our rise over run. So let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1 over. Ah, there we go. So we're going to dot there. Those are our two dots. All right. What happens if we do, let's clear that out. What happens if we do nothing here, zero there, plus the y-intercept? So we're going to say a 3. We can kind of leave this off. I mean, we know it's a 0. All right, so then that gives us no slope at all. You don't go up or down because our slope is gone. It's disappeared. All we have is the y. So y right here. Let's go down the y and let's get to our 3. All right, so y equals 3. What happens if we have an x there? Because we did talk about the x-intercept before, right? So our x-intercept would be here at the 3 here. So we're going across the x-intercept and we're dotting that 3 right there. All right. All right, guys, that's all I'm going to show you right now. Hope you learned a couple of things, some more technical things about y equals mx plus b. Now we move on to solving the problems to get it to y equals mx plus b. All right, thanks, guys.